Every citizen has a duty towards his country and the society. I somewhere felt people have a general fear of law, and so felt the need or the urge to create this documentary. I think as a whole, the society would be benefited.
And today, we are meeting a young director, Mr. Sourav Sarkar. He has made different kind of films like short films, documentary films and feature films as well. So today we are meeting him and we would like to know about his new film. Hello sir.
Yeah, hello.
So what is your film about? What is a new film about?
My new film is about, it is about law and judiciary as a whole. But in specific it is about a segment of our judicial reforms. That is public interest litigation.
So our viewers must be keen to know what is public interest litigation.
See, what is public interest litigation and all this I am not entitled to say in an interview.
Okay.
Because it for that you have to see the film. Actually you can read books and all, there also it is written what is public interest litigation, but making a film on that it does not just say what is a film, what is the definition and what are the technicalities. It is not made for that. For studying a technicality and all, that is available in books and everywhere.
Okay.
So there is something else in the film which may be expressing some emotion, which may be expressing some dreams of the citizens, which may have a connection with public interest litigation. But just this much I can say, that public interest litigation is something to utilize for welfare of people.
Okay.
But how it can be utilized and how it has been utilized for welfare of people, that we have tried to communicate through the film itself.
So all of us have to watch the film to know what is public interest litigation and also to know about the film. So sir, why this subject?
See, actually earlier I have worked on different other subjects like there is aging, there is childhood related matters was portrayed in my film, and my feature film was there that was on mother and motherhood, the bigger subject.
Yes.
The mother and motherhood. But all the subjects have something in common, which is, you can say, a connection to the society and the social conscience.
Mm-hmm.
And portrayal of human emotion. Actually, in all films it is done. But in specific, if you ask me, mm-hmm. why you have chosen a subject which is directly related to law and judiciary,
yes.
then I will say the answer will be, usually law and judiciary, it is a part of social science which is hugely connected to human beings, the society. But when there is some audiographic or audio video work on that, that is mostly for only the academic construction, for that is mostly informative. But the emotion part, the artistic part, that is usually not much mixed with the law and judiciary.
Yes.
So this time I had an intention to work on this subject so that the thought of art, the way of expressions, the way of human emotions,
yes.
can be little mixed up with the legal and judiciary system of our country, and angle of seeing it in an artistic manner. So in an artistic manner, the matter is portrayed, the system is portrayed,
mm-hmm.
the system of public interest and its utility is portrayed. Because as when the human dream comes relating to a law or one legal construct,
mm-hmm.
the dream of the society, it has a connection. Law is just not something very dry or anything. It has a connection with some betterment or welfare of people. So there is definitely human emotion with it. That is our work.
Okay.
Okay. Our work means the artist's work,
mm-hmm.
or the filmmaker's work. So that way it has the connection.
So now we have got a little essence of what is this film about. So my next question will be to you is, what kind of film it is?
It is actually a documentary film. short length documentary film. The film has a length around 20 minutes. I have films of different lengths. This one is 19 to 20 minutes.
And I would like to know who are the viewers?
Whenever you make a film, the viewers all are the viewers, all the citizens are the viewers. But in specific, if you ask me,
yes.
Then when a documentary film is made, mostly there is a learning goal. When a person will see the film, then he or she will learn something. Learning and teaching are different, okay? When we make a film, we don't try to say that this means this, this through this, this should happen. It is not the work of a filmmaker. But when a documentary film is made, and a fiction also, but in specific, we can say when a documentary film is made, that time the goal is to touch the learners. Anybody who is a learner is a viewer of the film. Now, so the question takes a different turn, that who is a learner? Anybody who is a learner is the viewer.
So talking about law and judiciary, an interesting point comes from the viewers and from me as well. So don't you think law and judiciary is a subject very much distant from the film and artwork?
What you have said, that is the truth, I think, at present, because of our historical legacy, that our law and judiciary, the system, which has much closer connection with police, closer connection with fear, that there, if there is a crime, then law and judiciary will come up.
Because, sorry for interrupting, but the thing is, nobody talks about this,
yes,
law and
yes,
judiciary.
Yes, yes, because firstly, there is no much teaching and learning both.
Yes, people know very much less about it.
Yeah, from the ground level, I think there is less teaching and learning.
Yes.
So people, it is still a matter of fear. Earlier, from the colonial period, it came, the legacy was like, it is a matter of fear, it is a matter of crime, police, then police custody, then the law and judiciary is mostly connected. Whenever this words are uttered, then people think this way. But the philosophy of our constitution, the constitution of India, and our legal system is not that, because we are in free country, and law and judiciary is a part of social science, which is for our security, protection of rights. It is just not a matter of crime and law.
So there are many books which are available, and also online facilities we have,
yes,
from where we can gather information.
Yes.
And yes, people do gather information from the internet and the book.
Yes.
So why to watch a film?
Why to watch a film means, I think what you are trying to ask is,
yes,
why to watch a film on a legal subject?
On this particular topic.
Yes,
yes.
Which has a lot of informative part.
Yes.
Then why to watch a film on this? People read books and websites, they will see.
Definitely.
No,
yes.
It's not a matter of replacing the requirement of reading books and websites.
Okay.
You have to, if you want to have a proper learning on, say, the subject of public interest litigation on which the film is made. So it is, my film is not going to replace the requirement of reading books and all. You have to read the books, you have to read the websites, you have to read the history for all details. This film is a way of seeing. It is a way of seeing the construct of public interest litigation or the legal and judiciary system of the country through an artist's view, through a filmmaker's view. It has certain emotional connections with certain information. See, public interest litigation is a big subject. It cannot be, if you want to cluster all the information on it, it will take a big length. It is a very big length, it will happen. And there can be books on that. But when a person is interested in knowing on the matter, he will read books, he will go to the library and all the things, then he can see this film also.
So now an important question I would like to ask you. That is, what is the name of this film?
Before that, I will ask you, why you did not ask this question in the beginning? It is an important question. You were saying you did not ask this question. Why you are asking
that? I would like to, I mean, I was trying to create a suspense for the audience, yes, as well.
So the name of the film is The Humane Judicature. The Humane Judicature. The Humane Judicature. Judicature is the judicial structure, construct. And human means which has a humanity. So I told you in the beginning that it has a touch of soulfulness. So that's why the name is like this.
So what is the message from your end for the viewers?
See, the message is provided through the film. So apart from the film, a director on the film, when he is talking on the film, he should not have a specific message in regards of the film. When the film is just on the verge of release or just on the verge of exhibition to the people. But as a filmmaker, through my experiences, I wish to request my viewers to see this film with a mind of looking into discovery, discovering things, discovering the small nuances of information, information processing also, at the same time the emotional touches, how things are portrayed. So
with an essence of law.
With an essence of law and some basic learning of the soulfulness of legal and judicial.
So, sir, it was a wonderful experience for me and for the viewers to know about your films. We were talking with Mr. Sourav Sarkar. Thank you so much.
Thanks.
And I was hosting. I am Anindita and Namaskar. Take care of yourself and have a nice life. Thank you.